Glory to the gang. Glory to the gang. You know what I'm saying? Top of it, top of it. You know what I'm saying? Let's add people to the live. Let's add people to the live. You know what I'm saying? Blessings to everybody in the live. Let's add more people to the live. Top of it. God's gift to the game. Top of it. Blessings to the G-A-M-E. Blessings to the game. We're going to add more people to the live. Tonight's live is Don't Let Her Break You for Your Energy P. You know what I'm saying? Pippin' Fat. Top of it. Let's add more people to the live. We got a good live tonight. Top of it. You know what I'm saying? Let's add more people. Hold on real quick. You know what I'm saying? We're going to talk about it for sure. Blessings to the gang. Blessings to everybody. Ice cold. You know what I'm saying? Hey. Skid 700. Shout out to my cuz. Let's add people to the live. Don't let her break you for your energy, Pete. You know what I'm saying? Back door 200. Top of it. Yeah, I'm saying we got a special live tonight, man. It's called Don't Let Her Break You for Your Energy P. And even if you're not in this lifestyle, you know what I'm saying, you can still utilize the information. You know what I'm saying? Don't let anybody break you for your energy. You know what I'm saying? But in this situation, in this particular topic, you know what I'm saying, I'm letting it be known, don't let her break you for your energy, because I see a lot of individuals that profess to be this pimping, but they stressing like they working at Target. You know what I mean? They stressing like an employee at Target. You know what I'm saying? And you know, you want to passionately pimp. You want to be proud when you pimping. You don't want to be, you know, call yourself pimping, losing hair, losing weight, or gaining weight, looking like a sloppy Joe sandwich at the end of the day. So it's imperative at the end of the day that we don't let that bitch break us for our energy. And any man in general, don't let a bitch break you for your energy. You know what I'm saying? Because how can you give something that you don't have? I'm going to give you a prime example. There's a lot of individuals that come to me and say, yeah, P, I got action. Motivation to the game, top of it. It's a lot of people that tell me that they got action from the bitch. Yeah, P, I got action from the bitch. You know, she's trying to leave her folks. She's been trying to leave her folks for a minute now. You know, she's been telling me that she's been trying to leave them. And you know what I'm saying? But she just don't know how to leave, P. You know what I'm saying? Top of it. She don't know how to leave. And she telling me that she want to come right. Free Rude. Top of it. She telling me that she want to come right and she don't know how to leave him. He's overly excessive. Or murder. Top of it. Let's add more people to the live. And the reality is this. She's breaking you for your energy already before she even so-called chose you. Because you're already thinking of a philosophy and a strategy to get the bitch to you. If you have to give the bitch game on how to come to you, she's not choosing you. They pimping on pins and needles, not in passionate, not in paradise. Yeah, they pimping on pins and needles and not in paradise. Facts. You know, they on their tippy toes, you know what I mean? They can't even put their foot down, you know what I'm saying? They on pins and needles, and they're not pimping in paradise. Facts, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, the bitch said she's trying to leave him, and she want to come correct. She don't want to come with me, just anything. And I'm trying to figure a way, because he got the bitch ID. He got the bitch bags, you know what I'm saying? I'm here to tell you that it's not your job to give her a way or a game on how to leave her folks. See, once somebody that's choosing you, she's going to find a way to get to you. She's going to find a way to choose you. Because if you get that bitch away and a strategy or a game on how to leave, at the end of the day, you're already setting yourself up for failure, because that bitch can go right back to where she came from. You know what I mean? Did she really choose you if you had to give her information on how to come? You know what I'm saying? So, you know, people that's telling me, yeah, P, it's been 3 weeks now, P. I'm talking to her. I think she getting close. Yeah, P, it's been 8 months. You know what I'm saying? The bitch said, I got action. You don't got action until that bitch give you a transaction. Hoop money, top of it. You know what I'm saying? As my brother Sinful used to say, you know what I mean? You don't got action unless that bitch give you transactions. So all that, I've been talking to her for this long, she playing with you. You know what I'm saying? That bitch is playing with you. You know what I mean? And I know that everybody's not in the live right now. Desiree, top of it. You know what I'm saying? I know some people that's not in the live right now, you probably around a bitch and you don't want her to listen to the live, so I understand. You know what I mean? Or the bitch is in the car and you don't want her to listen to this pimping, I totally understand. You know what I'm saying? You like can get a new bitch, she can get a new ID. Let her hold her hot. Yeah, it's a lot of dudes holding a bitch hostage. It don't count unless you can count it. Facts. That's something that Sinful used to say a lot. It don't count unless you can count it. You know what I'm saying? I can't count what a bitch say. I can't even bank on what a bitch say. But I can if the bitch send it in the bank. 10K. You know what I'm saying? Top of it. You know what I mean? Because a bitch could tell you anything. I'm going to come right. Sometimes bitches be, you know what I mean? Hey, baby. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm going to call you back. Hang up on you. And you like, all right, cool. The bitch is about to come through. You know what I mean? Just to hop up on the phone with you again and tell you I'm going to think about it. The bitch is breaking you for your energy. You know what I'm saying? Because the reality is, a bitch don't got to think about if she like you or not. You know what I'm saying? If a bitch saying she's thinking about choosing or she's thinking about that, she's really thinking about the situation. She's really thinking about how much leverage can I get over you or the other guy I'm dealing with. She's really thinking about how much dick that she's going to miss out on if she go choose with some authentic representation. I'ma just kick it. I gotta say it. She's thinking about, are you gonna be what he used to be or more? You know what I'm saying? Are you gonna give me all the dick I ever wanted? If you're not gonna give me all the dick and do all the sexual things and sexual favors that he did, I don't know if I wanna choose you. Her mind was made up from the jump. Her mind was made up for the jump. She don't gotta think about it. Now you keep on talking to this bitch or keep on trying to persuade a bitch, you know what I mean? And convince the bitch to fuck with you at the end of the day. Not to choose you, but to fuck with you. You know what I mean? All she's doing is saying, okay, I see that you really want me. So what a bitch will do is she'll start to play with you because she see that you really want her. Whether she's going or staying. Yeah, her mind was made up whether she's going or staying. She's trying to see who gonna let the bitch be more lazy. Yep. How much do you want me? Because however much effort you put into the bitch, at the end of the day, what it's going to tell her is how much she can play with you. A lot of hoes be on that too. Yeah, just a lot of square ass bitches. Let me say that again. As much effort as you put in and how you explain yourself and giving this bitch all different type of logical and explanational and psychological and physiological reasons, the anatomy, you bringing up all this shit. That she said, okay, he's trying so hard. Now I know I can play with him. I got him where I want him to be. Because you're trying so hard. And the last couple of dudes, she know that them niggas wasn't trying. Them niggas didn't put in no effort. Yeah, bitch, go outside and make it happen. Yeah, bitch, suck this dick and come back with the money. Just like that. And here you are with the coldest analogy in astrology. You giving this bitch a Martin Luther King, Malcolm X speech on why she should choose, when the other dude, she gave him everything, and you know, he didn't have to tell the bitch nothing. She gave him everything, and he didn't have to tell the bitch nothing. Browsy, I'm Nika, you know what I'm saying? Blessings to everybody in the live, you know what I'm saying? Add people to the live, be a blessing to this game, and add people to the live, you know what I'm saying? The topic is, don't let her break you for your energy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so if you waiting weeks and months for a bitch to chew, you need to cut that shit off. You need to move on to another bitch. You need to go knock you another bitch and put yourself in a position to where, you know, a young lady is choosing you. When you let her do what she wants to do, and that's not what she needs to do, you just been finessed. She's finessing you for your energy. She's breaking on you for your energy. And a lot of dudes will say this. Oh, man, I'm just breaking on a bitch, man. You're not breaking on the bitch if you stressing out. You know what I'm saying? If you losing hair and you... And I'm speaking from my own personal experience because these are some things that I've went through. If she's breaking you for your energy, you're not really breaking the bitch. You know what I mean? You got a lot of bitches telling you, I'ma think about it. I'm here to tell you that if a bitch tells you, I'ma think about it, that means no. And if the bitch does come, you might say, well, P, I had a bitch tell me she go think about it, she still came. Well, okay, she said she thought about it, but I guarantee you that bitch was a headache. I guarantee you that you got in the continuity of mashing on the bitch or just being angry because, you know, the mashing is for the hoes. You know what I'm saying? And pimps mash. You know what I mean? But you get in such a continuity of emotionalism and you so angry because the bitch is just so rambunctious and ignorant, outlandish. You know what I'm saying? Chronically outlandish. She's a chronic faggot. You know what I mean? But had you learned about all of that, you know what I'm saying? Of course. Right? So if a bitch tells you, I'm going to think about it, just know if you get the bitch, she's going to be a headache. Because her thinking about it is not her thinking about if she likes you or not. Let me just say that. Her thinking about it is not, do I like you or not? No. It's thinking about, how can I benefit from this? How can you help benefit me for somebody else? You know what I mean? No face, top of it. Blessings to everybody in the live. And before we continue, I don't condone or promote any criminal activities whatsoever. I'm an entertainer, an educator that's simply motivated by a particular lifestyle. Bitches telling you that they're intrigued, but, you know, the bitch ain't sending you no money. You know what I'm saying? You keep explaining to yourself, you know, why she should choose. And, you know, it's going to be good over here. And the bitch hasn't gave you no reason why you should be even talking to the bitch. You giving her every reason why. You explaining her, you know, I got the cars. My bitches got cars. We got a spot. I'm a man of integrity. You explaining all this shit. The bitch ain't gave you no reason why you should even be talking to her. It's already too many bitches, you know, that have guys that's trying to prove themselves to the bitch. Don't you be one of them. Don't try to prove yourself to the bitch. You know what I'm saying? That she didn't choose you if you had to prove yourself to her. Top of it. You know what I'm saying? And my thing is this. A lot of dudes is doing a whole bunch of curricular activity just to get the bitch. Some of the dudes is authentic pimping, but they want to be like the rappers. They want to be like the yimping. They want to be like the gangster pimping. You know what I'm saying? They're imitating and emulating and putting on a false persona as if they this gangster dude. You know what I'm saying? Just to impress the bitch, because a lot of these goofy ass bitches like basic motherfuckers. Big Mari Flames, top of it. You know what I'm saying? So my thing is this. If I got to be somebody else to have you, you don't deserve me in the first place. If I got to be somebody else to have you, you don't deserve me in the first place. Don't let her break on you for your energy. You know what I'm saying? You might have, bro, it's you have it or you don't have it. Exact. Yeah, no doubt. And my thing is this too. You know, you might have told a bitch to stop smoking, stop drinking, stop socializing. And you might have repeated yourself every single day. Don't let it be said her actions speak louder than your words. Peace and blessings, top of it. You know what I'm saying? Don't let it be said that her actions speak louder than your words. You know what I'm saying? Because there's a lot of dudes that's giving the bitch instructions and she's coming with the destructions. A lot of bitches, you try to instruct them, but she's talking to you like she's an instructor. You know what I'm saying? She's talking to you like she's the instructor. You know what I mean? But you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? She's talking to you like you're lucky to have her. A lot of bitches are saying, I'm thinking about it, as if they're doing you a favor. You know what I mean? Don't let a bitch talk to you like she doing you a favor. You the pimping. You know? See, a lot of these dudes is sucking on elbows, sucking on toes, and getting boogers out the bitch nose at the end of the day. You know, drinking the bitch bathwater and catching grenades for the punk ass bitch. And that's the reason why they feel as if I don't need to choose. I have too many options to choose. You know what I mean? Stop giving these bitches, and having game is not giving your philosophy to the bitch. Yeah, man, I was popping my game at her. That ain't game. You were just giving her your philosophy. And the bitch listened to it. You had an hour-long conversation with the bitch. Y'all talked about all the possibilities. But she didn't come with any transactions or action. She didn't come with anything. Nothing plus nothing equals nothing. You were talking to a bitch that didn't have any intentions of choosing. And you was in the car with her the whole time. And I'm gonna teach y'all this. Look. The best way to see if a bitch is serious, because a lot of bitches get on your lines and they talk about what the her folks, quote unquote, is not doing. You know what I'm saying? And this is also breaking you for your energy. Like you said, don't stress like a Target employee. Facts. Don't stress like a Target employee. It's a lot of dudes that call themselves pimping, man, and you would think that, man, pimping don't seem fun at all. I would hate to be a pimp. You know, you got pimps losing their life, get shot on camera, you know, screaming at the top of their lungs, veins popping out their neck. You know what I'm saying? It vexed my spirit to see some, you know, what they would call authentic representation and somebody that's a gentleman of leisure stressing out so much. I mean, goddamn. You got pimps beating up bitches in the streets, quote unquote. And let me say this, pimps don't beat up bitches. You know what I mean? But I'm going to speak on that topic later. You know what I'm saying? And my thing is this, you didn't put your hands on the bitch several times for being quote unquote out of pocket, and she still disrespected you. You didn't beat the bitch up. You can't beat the faggot out of a bitch. And it's a difference between discipline versus abuse. Discipline means the bitch want to stay. Abuse means the bitch want to go. And there's ways to discipline somebody. You know what I'm saying? But even that, she's breaking on you for your energy. Don't let a bitch break on you for your energy at all whatsoever. Because if a bitch knows she can break on you for your energy, because you got to think about it, that stops you from campaigning at another bitch. Some bitches don't deserve your energy. Some bitches don't deserve your time. You know what I'm saying? They don't deserve that. You know what I'm saying? And my thing is this. This is another example of a bitch breaking on you for your energy. You might have had the bitch for 7 months or a year. You know what I'm saying? You might have had the bitch for 8 months. You might have had the bitch for some time, right? And you gave her all the game you can give her. You know what I'm saying? Just for her to leave you. You know what I'm saying? And then within that time, that 7 to a year, within that time period, she was giving you problem after problem after problem until she ran into a gangbanger or a scammer that she liked. And she left you. She took all your game, and she wasn't exemplifying your game while she was with you, quote unquote, with you. But you know what I'm saying? She wasn't exemplifying it to the fullest degree. She wasn't reaching for it. She wasn't being the best that she can be. You know what I'm saying? Just for her to leave you, and then she start paying this gangster or this gangbanger. And since he has the materialistics, you would think that he's some authentic representation. And then she's doing every single thing that you taught her, but she's doing it to a different level. She's doing it at a whole different level. She's glowing. She look better. She's in pocket, quote unquote, in pocket. You got to have a pocket to be in pocket. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, she's not paying you no mind. When you sweating her, she's hitting the whole spin on you. You know what I mean? Baby K, you know what I'm saying? Baby K mover, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to that Richmond, you know what I mean? But she's super in pocket on you, quote unquote in pocket. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, while she's paying this person, You know what I'm saying? While she's paying this person, you still talking to the bitch. And she, yeah, and you basically apologizing to the bitch, you know, even though she left. Even though she decided to go pay a scammer or a gangster, you still, you know, when you come back, it's going to be different. Why are you apologizing to this bitch when she was chronically out of pocket? She left you, and you being apologetic to the bitch. You know what I'm saying? And she playing you because you continue to talk to the bitch. And she hasn't gave you a dime. You continue to talk to the bitch. You know, you didn't had her for all that time. It's just that I didn't like how you masked and how you used to never believe me. You know what I mean? She's sucking you for your energy. It's a bitch out there that's not going to say you didn't believe me. Because the truth is more important than me believing a bitch. Let me say that shit again. You know what I'm saying? The truth is more important than me believing in what the bitch said. And there's a bitch out there that wants to exemplify the truth. That wants to stand in the truth. Bitch, it's not my job to believe what you said, bitch. You don't believe when I tell you this. Show me through actions, bitch. You know what I mean? Show me through act. All this, you didn't believe what I said. Basically, the bitch is saying, you know what I mean? I couldn't lie to you, so I decided to leave. You no longer believe my lies, so I'm leaving. Stop letting her drain you for your energy. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, you might have said you broke on a bitch, but these bitches don't give a fuck about the money. These bitches don't give a fuck. That's why bitches pay bitches, dykes, homosexuals, transsexuals. You know what I mean? If a bitch can give money to a vibrator, the bitch would do that too. The bitch give money to light poles. You know what I mean? All type of shit. Grannies, aunties, all type, man. These bitches pay anything. These bitches don't give a fuck about the money. And when you say it's not about the money, it's different when she says it. Those are two different, they're coming from two different places. When a pimp says it's not about the money, it's coming from a different place, meaning moral standards, principles, etc. Gang, you know what I'm saying? That tatted gent, top of it. Blessings, you know what I'm saying? When the pimp says it's not about the money, it mean one thing. When the bitch says it's not about the money, a lot of times what they saying is they want some dick. They want love. They want comfortability. They want somebody that's like a boyfriend. So when they say it's not about the money, they mean what they say when they say that. You just have to unfold that. And I'm helping you unfold it right now. When they say it's not about the money, it's not the same thing as when the pimp says it's not about the money. They don't give a fuck about the money. They know you care about the money. That's why they're giving you a headache. You know what I'm saying? They know you give a fuck about the money. And a lot of the times, a lot of them suck you for your energy because there's one bitch. Because you got one bitch problems. She's giving you a headache because she knows that you're depending on her. She know that you don't believe in your game. She know that you're not going to fire her because she's the only bitch and you got bills, which is understandable. But at the same time, you know what I'm saying? Don't call yourself breaking on the bitch if you're around her. A bitch will get mad and have your car towed by the repo man that be on the blade trying to sweat the bitch. Exactly. These bitches do some outrageous things to drain you for your energy. Put holes in your car, break your window, tell other bitches don't fuck with you. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? All type of shit. Tell pimps that you wasn't doing no pimping. Draining you for your energy. She, you know what I'm saying? She sucked you dry. And you know what I mean? And she really didn't even have to try to suck you dry. She didn't respect you in the first place. You know what I'm saying? How can you give enlightenment and encouragement if you can't give what you don't have? She sucked you dry for your energy. And let me say this too. Yeah, the bitch might look good. You know what I mean? But every 5 minutes, the bitch is telling you, daddy. You know what I'm saying? Or some of them don't even call you daddy. You know what I'm saying? Or whatever she call you, boo. Or you know, that's a shame that in this game, you got a lot of fellas allowing these bitches call them boo and babe. You know what I mean? That's just outland. That's ridiculous. You know what I'm saying? And anybody that's letting a bitch call him babe and boo, you should be ashamed of yourself. And you need to change that square ass shit. Don't let the bitch call you babe and boo. Unless you are a boyfriend. You know what I'm saying? If you're a boyfriend, you have no business trying to send your girlfriend. You know what I mean? But that's a different story as well. But yeah, you got a lot of bitches saying, you know, I need condoms. You know, can you cut? I need condoms. I need wipes. Can you go give me? I need some food. I need this. I need that. She's putting you to work. The bitch is sending you. When you gonna start actually standing on some pivot and, you know what I'm saying? Send a bitch. Let it be AOT, all on a trick, bitch. You know what I mean? You putting the pippin to work. That's why a lot of pippin be in distress. You know, that's why you got pippin having seizures and falling out and fainting and all type of shit, because she putting you to work. You know what I'm saying? That's why every time you look up, you see pimp after pimp complaining on Instagram. You know what I mean? Because a lot of times she putting you to work. You know what I mean? You got bitches saying, can you wait in the parking lot while I do this date, daddy? Come on. I mean, just crazy shit. I'm getting sweated. What do I do? You got dudes pulling up with life vests, security jackets, and a cape all at once. Pulling up. Hey, P. That's my bitch. She just drains you for your energy. And see, since she drains you for your energy, you want to take somebody else's. You want to take this man's life. Because your wife called you on the phone and said somebody keeps sweating you. You know what I mean? As much as niggas try to play Super P, she really be the kryptonite. Facts. Facts. Bitches have this mindset that, you know, I'm his weakness and he's my strength. I am yo, top of it. Score team 6, top of it. Just square ass shit. You know, I'm his weak. Bitch, why would you want me to be your weakness? And I'm his. This see, a lot of these bitches get these quotes from the, you know, Instagram reels and memes and shit like that. And they got this square analogy, this square philosophy on the game. I'm his weakness, bitch. I'm not your weakness, bitch. You know what I mean? Let the trick be weak for you. You know what I'm saying? I'm his weakness, and you know what I'm saying? He's my strength. So that lets me know that you want to give the instructions. You want to be able to pop it and put your foot down and instruct the pimpin' on what to do. Because a lot of these bitches, you know, if it was up to them, the pimpin' would go outside and sell some booty. You know what I'm saying? They'd kick their feet up. You need to hurry up and come back with it. If you leave it up to these bitches, don't leave it up to the bitch. Don't decide till it's too late to start pimpin'. Don't let her drain you for all your energy. To where you tired and you don't even know why you tired. The illest visionary, top of it. You know what I mean? You don't even, you see a bad bitch walk by. You know what I mean? You just let her walk by. You was about to say something, but you so tired because you've dealt with this punk ass bitch that you don't even say nothing to the bitch. You know what I mean? You don't even say nothing to the bitch because she sucked you for your energy. And that bitch at that grocery store, that bitch at that Walmart, that Kmart, that Target, that Jack in the Box, or Whole Foods, or that restaurant, that could have been your next knocking, but you missed out on that because she sucked you for your energy. Protect your energy at all costs. Big Fredo, top of it. You know what I'm saying? And my thing is this, when a bitch leave you, she bump her head, you know what I mean? She bump her head with a few suckers. She come back to you and she's doing the same things. She's doing the same things that she was doing. You know what I'm saying? The same thing she was doing before she left. You know what I'm saying? Before she left, the bitch was out of pocket. She was talking to pimps. You know what I mean? She was doing all type of shit. She left, came back, and she's doing the same shit. If you leave it up to her, she doesn't have the emotions to match your mind. You finessed yourself. Thank you. You finessed yourself. You allowed her to break on you and you finessed yourself. Because you could have had a new knocking, but you allowed this bitch to take your energy. Because these bitches don't give a fuck about the pimping. Majority do not give a damn about no goddamn pimp. They don't care about pimping. They want your energy. They want all of you. You know what I'm saying? The bitch wants all of you. She sucked you, just she left with somebody else, came back, still's on the same bullshit, because she realized that, you know, he wasn't going to be a boyfriend either, and you relinquish your energy to the bitch again. And let me say this too, because this is very important. This is very important. Every bitch is not your bitch to mash on. Every bitch is not your bitch to mash on. You know what I'm saying? If you have an outlandish, disrespectful, chronically disrespectful, faggot-ass bitch, and is to the point where it's really bad, leave that bitch alone. And I had to learn this from experience. Leave her alone. If it's that bad. You know what I mean? Now, I understand certain situations where it's like, damn, P, my pockets is tight. You know what I mean? My pockets is tight, P. Knock you another bitch. Or break her from a distance. But the first thing I said was knock another bitch. Because all money ain't good money. You know what I'm saying? All money is not good money. Some bitches will put you in a correctional facility or put you in that dirt over them blue faces. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, all money's not good money. But if the bitch is disrespectful and she just doesn't, she doesn't want to listen, why do you want to preside over a bitch like that? You know what I'm saying? Simple phrase, a question a long time ago, which I always liked it. Are you a pimp or did you just get lucky? A lot of people are just having a good run. You know what I'm saying? A lot of dudes have never been weeks holeless. They've never been they've never been a month, 2 months holeless. They're just having a good run. 3 years from now, they're not going to be in a lifestyle. Niggas going to be doing construction work. Niggas going to be at Tesla. You know what I mean? And like I always say, a lot of niggas going to be working at Chipotle. And let me say, there's nothing wrong with working at Chipotle. There's nothing wrong with being a man that knows how to cook. Women love men that can cook. So nothing against, you know, because somebody might be on this live and be like, Ron, I work at Chipotle. Nigga, what you saying? So, nothing wrong with working at Chipotle. You know what I'm saying? Because, hey, you know what I mean? You might have to fall back and lead a hoes to Ron. Shit, you know what I'm saying? Nothing wrong with working at Chipotle. Hopefully, I can go in there and you can, you know, whip up a burrito. I like chicken burritos. You know what I'm saying? Beans, rice, sour cream, guacamole. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, you know, hook a brother up. Shit, you know what I'm saying? You could make all my hoes, tacos and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong with making burritos. Work at Chipotle. Y'all think I'm playing, but I'm serious, though. For real, for real. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing wrong with working at Whole Foods. People act like if you're not a pimp, it's the end of the world. You know what I'm saying? You're not a pimp. Just because you're not a pimp don't make you a real nigga. It don't make you... Just because you're not a pimp, that don't mean that you're not a real nigga. You can still be a real nigga and not be a pimp. You can still work at Chipotle and be a real nigga. I had to put that out there, man, because you got dudes that's... Oh, man, you disrespected my gangster, nigga. You saying that I ain't no pimp, man. Look out for the pimping and add extra steak and chicken in the peas bowl, please. Facts. Yeah, man, look out for the pimpin' to add extra steak and chicken and a peas bowl, please. You know what I'm saying? Facts. Man, you crazy. That's a fact, though. For real, man. Look out for the pimpin', man. You know, we got enough dudes trying to be pimps. We got enough dudes that's yimping. Because, you know, nowadays, they totally excluded the P and they put a Y. And that's my question. Why do you profess to be this pimpin'? Shout out to Chipotle employees. Man, look, man, let me, I might as well change the pen to Chipotle employees. But, you know, this live is not about Chipotle. We making it about don't let the bitch break you for your energy. But still, man, you know what I'm saying? She's breaking you for your energy now because you're endeavoring to be in a lifestyle that's not for you. Brother, you wasting your time and your energy, man. You should be flipping burgers. You know what I mean? Come on, man. It's a lot of good mechanics. Some of y'all look like y'all make some mean cold barbecue. It's a brother in the game now. He look like he can make some good barbecue. And I keep telling him, brother, open up a fucking restaurant called Quincy's Barbecue. It's the perfect time to open up a restaurant called Quincy's Barbecue. It's perfectly fine to be who you are and not who you idolize. Facts. You don't have to idolize the pimp. You can respect pimping. One thing about me is I respect pimping. But you don't have to be a pimp. Because my question is, why do you want to be a pimp? You're wasting your energy. You letting the bitch, a lot of bitches are scared to tell you that you're not a pimp. She just doesn't want to break your heart. You know what I'm saying? Why you do it like that? Because people got hidden talents, man. You know what I'm saying? And they're allowing this lifestyle to hinder them from reaching their ultimate goals that they really, you know, they really designed to be a barbecue worker. You know what I'm saying? To whip up some barbecue. You know what I'm saying? They got no business being no fucking pimp. Leave this shit alone. You know what I'm saying? Leave the pimping to run, man. Shit. You know what I'm saying? And that, and like I was saying previously, yeah, hey, barbecue does, Quincy's barbecue does sound fire, though. Quincy's barbecue do sound good, though. You know what I mean? Quincy's barbecue, I can't lie. Can I get a thumbs up if that shit sound good? Quincy's barbecue sound like they have some cold potato salad, some baked beans, you know what I'm saying? Some barbecue chicken. Look at y'all. Y'all just are imagining it right now. Y'all just, you look, y'all looking at the plate right now as I speak. Y'all, oh, that do sound good. Quincy's barbecue on a hot ass day with some lemonade, two sides of supersized drinks. Oh, yeah, man. That sound good right now. Some Quincy's barbecue. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? See, I need to open up a restaurant. You know what I mean? See, I'm endeavoring to clean money, man. Look, at the end of the day, I'm going to be the first to do it. Since a lot of people don't want to stand in the truth, let me do it then. Shit. Let me open up a Quincy's barbecue so y'all can be, so y'all can whip up the barbecue for my hoes. But anyway, every bitch, I was popping at a bitch and her baby daddy came out with a cape. Oh my God. Oh, I didn't imagine the secret sauce. Oh, that would be cold. I ain't gonna lie. See, that's what we need to do. That's what we need to do. You know what I'm saying? And let me say this too. A lot of dudes, like, they got the multicolored Kool-Aid in the mason jars. Now y'all got me talking about food. See, you know what I'm saying? That's how you know the pimpin' hungry right now. I'm like, oh, that sounds good. Some barbecue? That sounds like some shit right now. I'm not going to lie. And that's another thing. Don't let her break on you for your energy from the standpoint of, this bitch not even giving you enough for you to even feed yourself, P. The room is $120. She gave you $350 by the grace of God. And then the bitch is hungry. Then you want to buy the bitch an outfit because you think that if you invest into your hoe, you know, because I see a lot of niggas saying that. Invest into your woman. But you're not giving your, she's not investing into you. Because everybody says you got to take risks in order to get what you want in life. Risks versus investments are two different things. You taking a risk with your health right now, P. You straining, you choking the bitch. You know what I mean? Every time you look up, the bitch is throwing bottles at your forehead. You know what I mean? The bitch is snapping her fingers. She's telling you lies and rolling her eyes and trying to manipulate you with between her thighs. She's getting to a continuity of having an attitude every second. You know what I mean? And she's draining for your energy because you popping some great information at this bitch. And that shit is not registering. Let me say this. If at the end of the day, you're not compatible, you know what I'm saying? If you guys are not compatible, I don't care how much game you got. I don't care how much game you got. She's not going to apply your information if you are not compatible. If your pimping is not compatible with her hoeing, it's not going to be compatible. It's not going to register. She's not going to manifest all of your great, brilliant ideas. Intelligence over ignorance and education over emotions. Facts. Yeah, throwing a bottle like a badass kid. Throwing a bottle at the pimp's head. And some of y'all got the nerves to take the bitch back. You know what I'm saying? Got the nerve to take. She's taking you for your energy. And Lord and behold, I hate to say this, some of the bitches are breaking on y'all. You know what I'm saying? Now, you know it's bad if the bitch is breaking on you. So she breaking on you for your energy, and she's literally breaking on you like a trick. How come this bitch gets to be out of pocket, talk rambunctious, you know, not even hoshalize, because you gotta be a hoe to hoshalize. Gossip amongst other bitches, and she still get to get fucked at the end of the night. Some of y'all hide behind this pee. You know what I'm saying? She still get the dick at the end of the night. This bitch, see, I'm not into doing things for no reason. I'm not into doing things without a purpose. If you don't know your purpose and she don't, then it's just a toss-up situation. Stop trying to give this bitch words of exhortation and motivation when she wants a thug. She wants a gangster. She's a reprobate bitch. Sinful did a video called Reprobate Bitch. I want y'all to check it out. You know what I'm saying? They P stand for penetration. Exactly. They just want a bam, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. A gopher looking to go into another hole. They P stand for penetration, man. They chicken tender underneath the zipper. They just have to get that issue. They want the issue more than the bitch sometimes. When I say my issue, that's different than when they say they want their issue. You know what I mean? The P stand for two different things. If we in a circle, we popping, pipping, and the dude going, yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? I was wearing the bitch out last night. Yeah, I was wearing the pussy out. No, the P don't stand for that, brother. We're not talking about that. A lot of dudes, man, you doing more to keep the bitch than she is to try to even endeavor to get your trap. This bitch is doing nothing to even, and trying this line by the end of the day, but she's not doing anything to show that she's a representation of you, but you still giving this bitch game. I'm here to tell you that even mashing on a bitch is giving her game. Because a lot of dudes mash, but what was the message within your mashing? Yeah, I'm mashing with a passion, but what was the message? Because otherwise you just sound angry. You just wasting your energy. When you know that this bitch, you told this bitch numerous times not to do this, not to do that, and she continued and repeatedly done the same thing repeatedly, you're breaking yourself for your energy. And I'm here to tell you that every bitch is not going to live up and be a living representation of your pimping. Every bitch is not. So no, you don't give every bitch words of exhortation and motivation. You don't give all your game to every bitch. Some bitches are going to be there to choose you. You know what I mean? Some bitches are there to choose you, and some bitches are there to pay for game. Some bitches are there to choose you through the game, and some bitches are there to pay you for game. What does that look like? Because I want a lot of people to come away with something profound within this live. What that looks like is like this. If she's not following the instructions, she's disobedient, she's rambunctious. You know what I mean? Everything you stand for, she goes against. That's not a bitch you give your energy to. Then you have some bras that will listen to a certain extent, but she fully hasn't applied all of your information, but she listens just enough to get the money. But she hasn't fully submitted. You know what I mean? Like, for example, you might take the bitch to Vegas, or you might take her to a certain place and have her play a casino, right? The bitch might break that first night or that second night. And since she's seen that she can break, she no longer wants to apply the information with you. She'll do it for Willie Bo or Killer Mac. She don't want to apply the information with you. And when you see that, P, stop draining your energy. Stop letting her break on you for your game and your energy. Because you're giving her more game than she's giving you anything. Because it's not just about the money. You giving her more game than she's giving you anything. And she knows that. You know what I mean? So every bitch is not yours to mash on. Some people mash right away. But how you start is how you finish, P. You right. If the bitch comes off and she start off as she doesn't want to exemplify this game, and I'm ho-po, but this is a bitch that want to pay me and I could do it from a distance, break on that bitch. But don't give her your game and your information. She's not your bitch to give it to. And I say this too. Look, an out-of-pocket bitch has nothing to do with my pimping. But it could have everything to do with how I pimp. And the fact that I am pimping. What I mean by that is, a bitch can be out-of-pocket. A bitch can be disrespectful, right? She could be out-of-pocket. I could just break on her. I don't have to say anything amazing to this bitch. I don't have to give her any game. I don't even have to have a in-depth conference. I can start with the ABCs and just, hey, you know, I'm going to go pick that up, or, hey, send it through to here. You know what I mean? She out-of-pocket bitch out there that has nothing to do with my pimping. It doesn't have anything to do with how I pimp. You know what I mean? It has everything to do with her disloyalty. It has everything to do with the fact that she's not loyal. She's not committed to anything. And that, and it has everything to do with the fact that she might not want a pimp. So stop draining your energy, giving this bitch, teaching this bitch the word of the day. This is the word and quote of the day. She's not attentive to that. She don't give a fuck about that. Because as soon as you say that shit, you ever been talking to a bitch, right? And you saying some profound things, and she's looking out the window, and you ask the bitch, what did I say? And then she look at you, and she just starts smiling. Yeah, the bitch wasn't listening to nothing you say. Stop trying to give food for thought for bitches that want a feast of foolishness. Stop giving bitches food for thought when the bitch wants a feast of foolishness. Because soon as you say everything that you just said, she gonna go outside and do exactly what you told her not to, what you told that bitch not to do. You know what I mean? Stop letting her, you know what I mean? That's why I say, don't even run up in the bitch if she's not abiding by your information. Break on her from a distance and talk to that bitch nice. Don't give her none of your pimping. Don't give her none of your game. Well, P, it's about principles. A lot of y'all don't know the difference between principles versus pride. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people put their principles on things that they want to put their principles on. It's not something that they stand on a consistent basis. It's circumstantial. A lot of times it's just pride. It got nothing to do with your principles. The bitch hurt your feelings. So you got the prideful spirit thing going on. You know what I'm saying? And I'm here to say, I'm gonna be the first to say, there's nothing wrong with breaking on a bitch as long as she don't fuck with law enforcement. The bitch ain't, you know, stole from you or try to kill you or anything to that, or set you up. You know what I'm saying? And as long as she's not overtly disrespectful. Because I've dealt with all the things that I'm talking about, and I learned from them situations. I'm never gonna say, you know, I have all A's on my report card. I've made mistakes. I've fucked with some crazy bitches before. And that's why I can speak on this situation so eloquently. You know what I'm saying? Every bitch ain't yours to mash on. Every bitch, and I'm going to say this too. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people are giving bitches game based off their looks. You know, because it's a white bitch. I'm going to take her to Vegas. She broke on you from your energy right there. What has that bitch done to even deserve to go to Vegas? What has she went through? Just because she's marketable doesn't mean she even deserves Vegas game. This bitch don't deserve all that type of information just because she's a white marketable bitch. You know what I mean? That's crazy. But this other bitch, she had to go through hula hoops and, you know, all this other shit. And this is another way of breaking on you for your energy. A lot of you might have knocked a new bitch, right? You might have had the same bitch there for a couple of months, and then you knock something new, and that bitch that's been there is causing iniquities and problems within the household. You're going to always sound dumb to a bitch that can't comprehend your intelligence. Facts. If you try to give over the top intellectual information, logical information to a bitch that's basic, you know what I mean? You're going to blow a basic bitch because she wants basic shit. Basic bitches fuck with basic ass niggas. You know what I mean? She'll never operate on the same frequency or energy as you, or the same vibration as you. That's why she's not breaking in Vegas. That, because sometimes the pimping's game is just more advanced than the bitch. What I mean by that is she doesn't have the mental capacity to actually apply your information. Some of these bitches don't even have the common sense. You're giving the bitch this information, she doesn't even have the common sense to apply what you're talking about. And since she doesn't have the common sense, because it says don't cast your pearls among swine. It says that in scripture, it says that in Proverbs. Stop casting your pearls among swine. Stop giving this bitch everything when she doesn't deserve it. But some, you know, there might be another woman that came, another broad that came in the household, right? And she's causing iniquities and problems and trying to discourage the new bitch that came because she wants to be the only one. She broke you for your energy if you brought them bitches together. Say, Pete, talk about the fine line between loyalty and convenience. That'll be a good topic, but that's a little off topic. You know what I mean? Loyalty, people can be loyal to, I'm going to speak on it anyway. People can be loyal towards the wrong things. You know what I mean? A broad can be loyal towards the wrong things. She's breaking on you for your energy if you don't put that bitch to the test troubles and times to even establish if the bitch has any type of loyalty. You know what I mean? If you give the bitch everything without her even working for anything, you've just enabled the bitch. And a lot of dudes don't know that she'll never reach, you know, her potential within the lifestyle because, you know what I'm saying, she broke on you for your energy. You didn't put your foot down. You didn't check that bitch when she should have got checked. You didn't put her through no test troubles and times to see if she had any loyalty or commitment. So she broke on you for your energy and she wasn't able to reach the heights that she was supposed to reach within the lifestyle because you were an enabler of that. The only way you can see if she's loyal is through test. The game's going to test her and you can also test that bitch. You know what I mean? But I like commitment more than loyalty. Because commitment at the end of the day, it requires persistence and consistency. People think that love stems from, you know, commitment stems from love. Commitment does not stem from love. Commitment stands from persistence and persistence. That equals commitment. In any test, troubles, and time. You know what I'm saying? IRPZ live, top of it. So at the end of the day, she has to be tested. The reason why you're going through those iniquities is because in the beginning, you didn't test the bitch. So that's why she's draining a lot of individuals for their energy. Energy is something that, you know what I mean, that you need. You can always get that money back. You can't get your time back. That, you know what I mean? You can always get some. You can always find a bitch to break. Because a lot of dudes have a bitter taste in their mouth because they allowed certain bitches to enter the household that didn't deserve to be there. You know what I mean? The bitch didn't deserve to be there. And at the end of the day, the best thing to do, if you have a bitch that's already out of pocket and you knock you a new bitch, is separate them bitches. Because you don't want her energy to affect another broad's energy. Especially if it's affecting yours. You know what I mean? The bitch might call your phone and start complaining about everything. A lot of times that's a manipulation tactic. So you can focus on her feelings or focus on how she feels so she can get away with some out of pocket shit that she's doing. See, and when you're thinking this deep, that means, you know what I mean, you need to get some more bitches. The reason why she's breaking you for your energy is because you got one bitch. Just imagine if you had a multitude of women that at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, that also were standing up for your pimping. Imagine, you know, even in Genesis, Adam and Eve. Imagine if, you know, Adam had multiple women. And see, you know, we can even look at 1 Kings with King Solomon. What happened to King Solomon? He was one of the wisest men in the world, but he allowed women to break on him for his energy. He allowed the women to convince him to admire a different god. They broke on King Solomon for his energy. Even scripture is giving you an example on how you should live your life. You can have all the wisdom in the world, but what good is it if you lose your soul? That's why we're in the world, but don't be of the world. You know what I'm saying? That's why it's very imperative that you consistently out and about. That's why it's very imperative that you, when you out campaigning, you don't just talk to any bitch. Because certain bitches, you know, a bitch might say something to you. You know, especially say if you ho-po and you don't got a bitch, a bitch might say something to you that might affect your energy. Now, every P is such a pimp that they're not going to say this, but I'm going to say it. Certain bitches might say something to you, and a lot of dudes, it's like, damn, you know, she was bad, and I know, you know what I'm saying, if you know, on a good day, or I know, you know, damn, you know, if this bitch don't like me, some dudes get discouraged. That's why you have to protect your energy. You can't pop at every bitch. Every bitch ain't worth your words of exhortation. And when you pop it to her, you can never get that back. Those words could have went to another broad that was very interested in you. And may have done some outstanding hoeing. Don't let her break you for your energy. Dudes, continue to the bitch keep on looking at your story on a continuous basis. She watching everything you post. She's liking everything you post. She's having conversations with you on the phone. You know what I mean? She's dragging you. A lot of bitches just want your information so they can use it for somebody else. Because if she don't come the way she's supposed to come in the beginning, then, you know, how you think the ending gonna end? You know what I'm saying? It's not gonna end the way you want it to. Stop entertaining these faggot ass bitches just because she watched your story, just because she liked your story, just because she reposted something you said. A lot of these bitches want to be they're in the lifestyle of pimping and hoeing to be a better square. A lot of these bitches, they putting their foot down with the pimping, and because they want the pimping, they view the pimping as potentially being a good baby daddy. These bitches, a lot of times they choosing on guys they see as a good father. You look like you would be a good father. And let me say this too. If it takes for another bitch to come, for the bitch to act right, she's an opportunist. You know what I'm saying? And the best way to know if she's some authentic hoeing is you knocking another bitch. That'll show you who the bitch is. And when that bitch gets into that continuity of being disrespectful when you knocked another bitch, don't let her drain your energy, because if you allow that bitch to be disrespectful while that new bitch is there, you're planting a seed in that new bitch's mind. So it's very imperative that you separate them bitches. You know what I'm saying? They're giving me 1 minute and 50-something seconds. I appreciate everyone that joined the live. I will have my YouTube page up soon. You know, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns, definitely contact me via Instagram. Or for those that have my number, you can contact me. I have my consultation information in my bio and on Instagram. Feel free to click on that. And if you want consultation, you can definitely hit me up and we can arrange that. Peace and blessings to everybody on the live. One.